KSPW weather with Jim VanderZwan.
Well, we had some hot, we had a little bit of cool along the coast. The weekend worked out just the way we figured. We're now keeping an active eye on the Doppler radar. We had some subtropical moisture coming up. It's putting up some pretty good thunderstorms in the high Sierra where the mountains are providing extra lift, and the lightning is the biggest threat. It's all high-based thunderstorms. Probably not much out of these guys here. It's just mostly mid to high-level clouds and adds a little bit more of that muggy feeling, but that's about it, at least for now. Overnight lows mild. I haven't got your 90s there. Boulder Creek, Ben Lomond, Scotts Valley, but not too bad in Santa Cruz. 79, 81 in Watsonville, and a little bit cooler, kind of getting back to normal, really. Mid-60s to low 70s around the peninsula. Still 86 in Carmel Valley, 84 in Big Sur, and Salinas still feeling like a coastal city here, 78. But by the time you get Gonzales, you're in the mid-80s and then mid-90s down to Greenfield, King City. South of there, still some triple digits, pretty hot in south end of the Santa Clara County and San Benito area, and 94 in Hollister at 102, the hot spot. That in Morgan Hill, plenty of 90s to go around, and then you get over the other side of the hill and it gets really hot. 110 in Redding today, Sacramento 105, 108 Fresno. Out in the deserts, you don't want to really go there. 114 degrees in Palm Springs in Las Vegas, and it's cooled down. It was 117 over the weekend in Vegas. And Death Valley, 128. Didn't quite get the hottest it's ever been there this time of year, but close. 110 in Boise, 112 in Phoenix. That doesn't happen every day, but look at Denver, only 82, 86 in Dallas, 78 in New York. You can tell where the high pressure ridge is right now. It's affecting the western third of the country. Upper level trough doing the other side of things here, bringing some moisture going south along the front end of that high pressure ridge. You got a clockwise rotation going on here. Thunderstorms moving that way. This upper level low is cranking in a lot of wet weather for flooding conditions along the mid-Atlantic states. Here you can see the upper level pattern. There's the low, and it's not going anywhere fast because of a high pressure ridge right here. So the parade is pretty much stopped. This moisture will continue to rain on areas that already have too much water. Wouldn't it be nice to grab this and park it over here for a while? But they're starting on somewhat of a monsoon flow in the southwest, but a long way away from breaking a drought. So much energy is coming in that it's diving down on what's left of this little low-pressure trough until this ridge moves inland. Meanwhile, we still pick up on the left flank of it some of that circulation for that subtropical moisture. Air mass still hot. 5,000-foot temperatures indicate it'll stay that way, but it starts to move out toward the desert in about Wednesday and Thursday, which allows things to cool down a little bit for the valleys. The coasts, we're already there. We're doing pretty good. We still have that sea breeze. Cool to mild overnight. Still pretty hot, though, in the south end of southern Monterey and northern San Benito County. Also in the valleys, all the way on up into Napa and Sonoma, it stays hot. And, of course, the Central Valley, as you can see, still pretty hot. We're cooling off, but no really chilly temperatures just yet outside of the sea breeze from the bay. And each day will knock a couple of degrees off that. By the time we get to Wednesday and Thursday, it'll be closer to normal, which is still pretty warm. But for now, the National Weather Service keeps that excessive heat warning in for the areas in red you see here, which doesn't include the Monterey Bay or the north end of the Salinas Valley out to about San Juan Bautista, because it's just warm. And that's okay. We'll lose that here in a couple of days. So we'll figure 70s on the peninsula, but a lot of 90s in the South Bay. Also in the East Bay, still that excessive heat, 90s to 100s. And once you get out to Piscinas and Tres Pinos, you're really pushing that mercury up there. And they could get way up there. Likewise, south of King City, temperatures 105 to 110 as you get down toward Camp Roberts and San Ardo and the like. 60s and 70s will do it for the peninsula, though, a little more comfortable. 80s in the valleys, some 90s still for the Santa Cruz Mountains. And we'll still do those low to mid 80s, so I guess you won't be alone on the beach tomorrow either. Partly cloudy, local fog near the coast might set up later on tonight, just patchy stuff, fairly low marine layer. You'll notice more the mix of mid to high level clouds, still hot inland, a little bit of a muggy feeling and at times during the day, but it all goes away. Most of the clouds gone, and after some morning sea stuff, we're back to normal. And by Thursday and Friday, 80s and 90s for most. We'll leave a few hundreds in the hottest spots. The beach is still looking pretty good with some night and morning fog. Low clouds may stick a little bit more over the weekend, but not enough to be a real nuisance yet. We've been cruising along here. And I should say Happy New Year. Today is the 1st of July. Yeah. It's a brand new fiscal rain year. So tomorrow I'll show you the rain totals from last year, from up to June.
Oh, there you go.
All right. Okay?
Okay.